Good morning, children. All of you, good morning. Here, today, we are going to learn a different concept in maths. You have studied in previous sessions about natural numbers, about whole numbers, about integers, rational numbers. About these number systems already studied in previous classes, in previous sessions. Here, natural numbers will be used to count objects. Those are 1, 2, 3, etc. Along with these natural numbers include 0. Include 0 to natural numbers. You will get integers. Whole numbers. Sorry. Here, whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. Along with these whole numbers, negatives of natural numbers means plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, which is the set of integers. Set of integers consisting natural numbers, whole numbers and negatives of natural numbers. Next, you had learned about rational numbers. Here, a number which is in the form of p by q, such that here both numerator and denominators are integers and denominator should not be equals to 0. Such type of numbers are known as rational numbers. Similarly, you had completed representation of these numbers on number line also. Suppose this is the number line. Suppose here mark 1, 2, 3, etc. Therefore, natural numbers represented on number line, which is completed. If you mark here 0, here 0 consisting whole numbers system. Therefore, set of whole numbers. Here, which is, consider this is the right side. Now, we are writing opposite direction of this right side is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 like this. Therefore, like this, in this way, integers also represented on number line. Similarly, represented rational numbers also number line. If you divide this into 3 equal parts, each part represented by 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 4 by 3, like that. Similarly, divide this into 3 equal parts. Here, which is 0 by 3, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 3 by 3, which is 4 by 3, 5 by 3, this is 6 by 3. Like this, in this way, we can represent rational numbers on number line. Here we have so many gaps between natural numbers, integers, between rational numbers also we have so many gaps. Now we want to fill them by some numbers. Here, between any two rational numbers, here which is the line, on the line we have infinite number of points, each point represented by a number. If you have a number, you can assign a point on the number line. If you have a point, we can write that point as a natural number or whole number or integer or a rational number. Like this, we can represent it rational numbers on number line. Here, suppose, consider this number. Here, which follows this rule. Therefore, this is the rational number. Now divide this rational number into two parts. Here which cannot be divisible by 2, that's why writing 0 and point. 2 5s are 10. Therefore 1 by 2 is equals to 0.5. Similarly, now consider another rational number 1 by 3. Now divide 1 into 3 equal parts, which is impossible. That's why writing 0, taking point. 3, 3s are 9. 10 minus 9, 1. Once again write 0. 3, 3s are 9. 10 minus 9, 1. Similarly, you will get like this. Therefore, here 1 by 3 is equals to 0.3, 3, 3, etc. Here means if you have a rational number, if you have a number which is in the form of p by q, we can write as like this. We may get like this decimal numbers. Here, in this division, we are getting remainder as 0. Therefore, in this case, this decimal is known as terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. Here, in this case, this decimal number is known as non-terminating repeating decimal. Here, 3 repeating again and again, we are not getting remainder as 0 here. Therefore, in this case, this decimal is known as non-terminating repeating decimal. Non-terminating repeating decimal. Means, if you have a rational number, we can write either as a terminating decimal or as non-terminating repeating decimals. See, suppose here, see, these are all rational numbers. Here 7 by 8 is there, 2175 by 625 is there. These are all rational numbers. Here, if you divide numerator by denominator, we are getting 0.875 here, which is terminating decimal. A digit not repeating after some decimals. Here, which is also, these are all terminating decimals. Means if you have rational numbers, we can write as terminating decimals. We can see some decimals as like this. Here see, minus 5 by 3, these are all in the form of p by q. Therefore, all are rational numbers. All rational numbers, these rational numbers written as in these forms. These are called decimal forms of these rational numbers. Here, after decimal, we have 6. 6 is repeating again and again. Here, 3 is repeating. 6 is repeating. 18, 18, 18. Here, group of digits repeating. Here, after 3, 5 repeating. Here, 14, 28, 57. 142857. Here group of digits repeating. That's why we are saying as non-terminating repeating decimals. If you have a rational number, we can write a rational number as terminating decimal or non-terminating decimals. Here important question is that. Are there any decimals other than 10 terminating decimals, non-terminating repeating decimals? This is the question we have to think today. Here, if you have your rational number, we can write this rational number as terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal. Here question is that, have you any other decimal numbers other than terminating decimals or non-terminating repeating decimals? We will think about this concept. Here answer is that we have another type of rational numbers, another type of decimal numbers. Suppose 0.10, 100, 1000, like this. Here, which is not a terminating decimal and not a non-terminating repeating decimal, which is a special number. 1.12, 112, 1112, like this. Here, these are the numbers not belongs to terminating decimals or non-terminating repeating decimals. Therefore, such type of decimals are known as irrational numbers. These are known as irrational numbers. Now, today we will learn about irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. Here, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers represented on number line. Here we got a special type of numbers. Those numbers are known as irrational numbers. Here, irrational numbers means which is non-terminating, non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. Here, these decimals does not belong to terminating decimals or non-terminating repeating decimals. Therefore, these numbers does not belong to this set of rational numbers. Therefore, such type of numbers are known as irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. See, in our mathematics, we have so many types of irrational numbers. Here, which is an irrational number. Here, which is non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. A group of digits not repeating. Therefore, non-terminating. Here in this also, these are all non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. Such a type of decimals are known as irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. Here, suppose root 4 is equal to what? We can write root 4 as 2 square under root. Square root cancel 2. Therefore, square root of 4 is 2. Similarly, square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 16 is 4. But what about root 2? What is the value of root 2? How we get root 2 value? Now, we will think. Here, is root 2 belongs to natural numbers, whole numbers, or integers, or rational numbers? We will think about that. Here, now I am using long division method to find out the square root of 2. Square root of 2. Here, 1 1s are 1, 2 minus 1, 1. Write 2 zeros. Here, after decimal, we have 2 zeros. They are writing here. Therefore, here, point. Now, double this number. Double this means multiply with 2. 2 ones are 2. Now, 24 fours are 96. We will get 4. Write another 2 zeros. Now, double this number. 14 twos are 28. Here, 28 ones are only 28. 28 twos are 56, which exceeds. That's why I am taking 1. Here also 1. 281 ones are 281. Now subtract. 1 plus 9, 10. 9 plus 1, 10. 3 plus 1, 4. Double 1, 9. Right? Another 2 zeros. Here, if you subtract 281 from 400, we will get 119. Now, double this. 2 ones are 2. 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2. Now, take 4. 4 into 4, 16, 4 into 2, 8, 9, 4 into 8, 32, 4 to the 8, 8 plus 3, 11. Now subtract, 10 minus 6, 4, 10, 9 minus 9, 0, 8 minus 2, 6. Now write another 2 zeros. Now double this, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2. Now continue like this, we will get root 2 value as 1.414213 like this. Therefore, which is the non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Such type of decimals are known as irrational numbers. Such type of decimals are known as irrational numbers. In therefore, this is the root 2 value 1.414213562 37. If we continue this process, we will get this type of digits after decimal, therefore which is non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. That's why which is an irrational number. Here now already proved root 2 as an irrational number, because of here root 2 expressed in the form of non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Therefore, root 2 is an irrational number. First, root 2 proved as irrational number by Pythagoreans. First proved Pythagoreans root 2 as irrational number. Then, Theodorus showed root 3, root 5, root 6, root 7, root 8, root 10, root 11, root 12, root 13, root 14, root 15, root 17 as irrational numbers. Theodorus of Cyrene proved these numbers as irrational numbers. Then we have irrational number is that pi. Proved this pi as irrational number. Here for this pi, first proved by Archimedes, this pi value lies between 3.140845, 3.142857. Here pi value lies between 3.140845 and 3.142857, which is proved by Archimedes. First proved pi value lies between these two values, these two decimal values. Then Aryabhatta showed pi value as 3.1416. Our Indian mathematician Aryabhatta proved this value, pi value as 3.1416. Then in 1700, Lambert and Legendre proved this pi as an irrational number. Pi belongs to an irrational number, which was proved by Lambert and Legendre in 1700s. Our great mathematician Einstein, born on March 14th. Here pi value is 3.14, etc. Therefore, here this represent 14th, this represent month. Here, March 14th considering as pi day. pi day. Here in our mathematics, these irrational numbers, have great importance. Suppose in trigonometry, sine 45 is equals to 1 by root 2. Sine 60 is equals to root 3 by 2. To find the area of circle, we will use pi r square. To find the total surface area of sphere as 4 pi r square. To find the volume of sphere as 4 by 3 pi r cube. To find the surface area of hemisphere as 2 pi r square. To find the total surface area of hemisphere as 3 pi r square. To find the volume of hemisphere as 2 by 3 pi r cube. Similarly, we will have, such type of three-dimensional shapes in our mensuration. Here, lateral surface area of curved surface area of cylinder is pi r l. Volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. Here, curved surface area of cone is pi r l. Here, volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Like this, we will use pi in our mathematics. Here, engineering revolves around structures, designs. All designs consists these geometrical shapes. Means, indirectly we are using irrational numbers in engineering also. In physics also. In chemistry. In solutions chapter, we will use an exponential constant. That is Euler constant. Euler constant is equals to limit of n tends to infinite 1 plus 1 by n to the power of n. Here this is known as Euler constant. Euler constant value, E value as 2.718281828284, which is also an irrational number. Pi also an irrational number. These are all non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. If a number has non-terminating, non-repeating decimal expression, that is known as irrational number. Similarly, we have phi also. Phi is a golden ratio, which is used in biological science. Phi value also an irrational number, which is also non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Therefore, here, up to here, learnt about irrational number. What are the uses of irrational number? Now we will define the irrational number. Here, root n is an irrational number if n is not a perfect square. That is known as an irrational number. Similarly, another definition also we have. If a number has non-terminating, non-repeating decimal expression, that is known as an irrational number. Like this, we will use irrational numbers. This is the definition of irrational numbers. Now, up to here, discussed about irrational numbers. But we didn't prove root 2 as an irrational number. We have another proof also to prove root 2 as an irrational number. To prove root 2 as an irrational number, first suppose root 2 as irrational number. Now we want to prove root 2 as an irrational number. To prove, I am using method of contradiction. That's why I am contradicting, supposing root 2 as a rational number. Now, divide and b by using HCF of a and b. Means indirectly we are just simplifying this fraction, this rational number. After simplifying, suppose we are getting p by q form. Means here p and q have not p and q have factors, have not any factor other than 1. Means indirectly here p and q have only one factor, that is what, 1. That's why here written p and q have not any other factor, have not any factor other than 1. Only 1 is the common factor. Now squaring on both sides, we will get 2 is equals to p square by q square. Means 2q square is equals to p square. Means q square is equals to p square by 2. Means 2 dividing p square. 2 divides p square. Here we have a theorem, that is that if 2 divides p square, 2 divides p also. Here 2 is dividing p means 2 is the factor of p. That implies 2 is the factor of p. If 2 is the factor of p, we can write p as 2 into something. Why? Here 2 is the factor of p. That's why we are writing this p as 2 into something. Now squaring on both sides, you will get 4m square. Here p square is equals to 2q square. Substitute that. 2q square is equal to 4m square. Here q square is equals to 2m square. Means q square by 2 is equals to m square. Means here q square divided by 2. Means 2 dividing q square. 2 divides q square. That implies 2 divides q also. If 2 divides q, 2 is the factor of, 2 is the factor of q. Means here according to these two statements, 2 is the common factor of p and q. But here supposed p and q have not any other factor other than 1. But here we got 2 as the common factor. Therefore which is the contradiction? Means indirectly root 2 is not equals to p by q. Means root 2 is not in the form of p by q. Therefore root 2 is not a rational number. Means indirectly root 2 is the irrational number. Here root 2 is not a rational number. Means root 2 does not satisfy this condition. Means root 2 is a number other than rational number. That is known as irrational number, which is the proof of irrational number root 2 proved here as an irrational number. Now here all numbers are represented on number line. Now we will think about root 2 can be represented on number line or not. Suppose take this as number line, mark here O. Suppose take 1 unit distance. At this point draw a perpendicular. Suppose this perpendicular length is 1 unit. Join O and B. Here apply Pythagoras theorem for this right angle triangle, that is OB square is equals to OA square plus AB square. Here OA is equal to 1, AB also 1. That is 1 plus 1. That is 2. Now OB square is equal to 2. OB is equals to root 2. Means which is the root 2. Now by using this length, draw a circle around O as the center. Here OB is equals to now suppose this point as OA. OB is equal to root 2 means this is also root 2 from here to here. At A1, similarly draw perpendicular from B1. Now join OB1. For OB1, A1, apply Pythagoras theorem. We will get OB1 as root 3. By using OB1 length, draw a circle which cuts our number line at A2. Now OB1 is equals to OA2, which is equals to what? Root 3. Now, if you want to get another irrational number on a number line, just extend this process, you will get root 5, root 4, root 5, root 6, root 7 can be represented on number line by using this process. Similarly, we can draw square root spiral also by using this process. Okay, thank you.